from Alicanto Minerals is Peter George. Peter, good morning. Happy New Year.
Yeah, happy New Year to you, Andrew. Good to see you again.
Good to see you, Peter. More significant results in here from drilling and rock chips at Sala. Give us a rundown as to the latest.
Yeah, so some really good results that we've had, with the drilling. And obviously our focus has been predominantly around the Prince lode, which was, I think, discovered back in the 80s. Bull Eden had put a number of holes into this going back then, had some success quite high up. We've been expanding on that, and that's been the main focus area for our maiden resource coming out soon. But we haven't been stopping there. We've now mobilised a third drill rig. And on top of that, we're now focusing on a number of other targets that sit just outside of the actual Prince lode itself. We've with that work and the geological review that we've been doing, we now have over 3 kilometres of strike of mineralisation where we can see this, popping in and out. Some very high-grade rock chips that we reported, over 1,400 grams per tonne silver at surface and 1% of copper. And with the copper, also comes the gold, which is the first time that that's been seen within the system as well. So a very exciting period that we're coming into now.
Tell me a bit more about the scale here, Peter. You make reference and some comparisons to the Garpenberg mine nearby.
Yeah, well, Garpenberg's only about 50 kilometres away. With Eric's background, our chief geologist, he was a chief geologist at Bull Eden going back when they made the major discovery of the extensions to the Garpenberg mine. Now, they now have over 30 years of production in front of them, which is a mine that they were about to close down in 2000. And we've been applying the same knowledge that Eric gleaned over there at Sala. And we now believe that what we're looking at here is of a similar scale to a Garpenberg. Obviously, it's time will tell as to whether we can get up to those amount of tons. But, the geology is looking very, very similar. And with the 3 kilometres of strike and sitting within the limestone hosted, area, it's got all the hallmarks for being huge.
And you're really thinking here's for the potential for a standalone operation, is it?
Yeah, well, it will be. I mean, obviously, my background being a mining engineer, I want to get the tonnage up as high as we possibly can before we get started. The maiden resource that we'll be coming out with, we may not get to that level to begin with, but, I'm pretty confident that we're going to be, with the drill rigs that we've got out there now, that we've got every opportunity in the near future to reach some serious tonnage in this thing.
Have you said when you're expecting to put out the resource?
Yeah, we are expecting to put it out this quarter. I guess the only thing that would potentially slow us down in that is that, we are hitting significant mineralisation in every drill hole. So we're going to have to cut that off at some stage so that we can report the maiden resource. I know that, a lot of our investors are very keen to see that number. So, we're working very hard in the background to deliver on that.
And well funded on the back of your recent capital raise to see you through the near term here.
Yeah, very well funded. Yeah, we raised $7 million towards the back end of last year. We're also about to get some cash in the door through the sale of our Guyana projects, which has been a long time coming, but I believe that's happening in the next week or two. So, we're all set up very nicely for the next 12 months.
Good to get an update. Peter, thanks very much.
Yeah, great, Andrew. Good to see you again. Thanks.